Is one of the craziest in the world for sure.
So eine Helme. Der Rave ist stabil.
Berlin for me is a lot about personal freedom.
It's like a phoenix, rapidly developed into hustling, bustling city now.
Diese ganze Mietervereinigung, die fand tatsächlich auf dem Dancefloor statt.
Friede. Freude, Eierkuchen.
Ich finde, der Sound wird auf der Tanzfläche entschieden.
You're God. You're like the man or the woman of the hour.
Berlin. The city that is beloved for its electronic music and admired for its nightlife. There are 3.6 million residents living in this city. Every year, 12 million tourists come and visit the capital. There are more than 300 clubs in Berlin. The exact number of DJs is unidentified, but for sure, there are plenty of them. The city of superlatives is known worldwide for its dark, anonymous, and innovative electronic music scene. That's why Berlin's unique scene is Europe's melting pot for millions of creatives, artists, and party people. Carolina has been part of this milieu for many years, but she never questioned why she feels so attracted to this city. What is the magic that surrounds this city? Where did it all start? How did it evolve, and where does it lead? This weekend, Carolina is going on a journey through this vibrant nightlife, following the trail of this mystery. She will meet people with whom she tries to fathom the roots of club development and techno movement in Berlin, and should lead to understanding a phenomenon that shaped a whole culture. Join and listen to the sound of Berlin.
There is no rules in electronic music. The only rule is basically to be creative. As electronic music is all about experimenting, there is no like correct genre. You can compose like deep house and techno together. You can take a classical piano and, I don't know, orchestra and put under it a techno beat.
Es gibt da keine Regeln.
Also klar, du hast eine Regel, es ist normalerweise ein Viervierteltakt und es ist halt eine Viervierteltel-Bassdrum drin, ja, und der Rest, da machst du halt das Beste draus. Wenn es um Techno geht, um dieses Brachiale, dann ist es einfach ein Gesamterlebnis. Musikalisch nimmst du es wahr und dann die volle Wahrnehmung passiert eben im Club oder auf dem Festival, wenn du es laut hörst und spürst. Meine erste Techno-Party, das war für mich einfach die Eingebung.
I see different tempos, different rhythms. I see the sound and different, you know, formats in a way. Specifically 4/4 rhythm. You know, you have a lot of 3/4 rhythms, 6/8 rhythms. You know, this is something that mostly only music people know, but it's definitely a noticeable trend.
About electronic music, that is this, yeah, that you have this body aspect and like being surrounded by sound and swallowed by sound. Like how much music can be an art performance and not just also sound experience, but also visually an experience.
Yeah, at an early age, I was obsessed with like 80s music, like synth new wave. So all the synthesizers, like that all just got thrown into me. Also, I was a huge Commodore 64 gamer. So I'd play Commodore 64 like every day with my brother. And all those melodies like would just like go into my brain. The first thing I did was like mix it all together and start making like 80s techno computer stuff.
Techno is a genre of music evolved over several periods. The germ cell of techno music has its source in Detroit, Michigan, USA. Around 1985, a different sound was created, which was based on industrial beats. At this time, techno represented everything that nobody had imagined so far. The movement of techno music spilled over to Europe in the late 1980s, where Berlin decisively shaped the development of techno culture in Germany.
Germany has always been a quality standard. You have a group here called Kraftwerk, which I think was from Dusseldorf, that definitely had a strong influence on my music. It showed me the preciseness of, you know, this German way of thinking, and it applied to electronic music. It was like, that was the beauty of the Kraftwerk. You know, that made me tighten up my screws a little bit more when I heard Kraftwerk. You know, and so I think that was one of the main influences that Germany had on us in Detroit.
Chicago was house, Detroit was techno, and if you were in Detroit and you listen to house music, people would like look at you weird and vice versa. people in Chicago would like say heck no to techno, and then the Detroit people would say fuck house, and it was like a big fight.
And Detroit was basically the only city in America outside of Chicago that was doing any type of progressive electronic dance music.
The only reason why it worked in Detroit is because there were so many empty warehouses. If you wanted to have a party, just look around. There's like 50 warehouses, pick one. And Berlin was like that too. There were so many empty places.
Detroit war zwar der Ort, wo diese Sounds entwickelt worden sind, aber der Ballon stieg hier in Berlin auf. Hier in Berlin war alles möglich und ich liebte es, diese Anonymität, weißt du. Und ich war auch wirklich überrollt. Für mich war das ein großer Kulturschock, so hier Menschen zu sehen, die ganz anders aussahen und diese Hinterhöfe.
Wie halt hier in Berlin so in Kreuzberg, das war schon sehr eigen, weil besetzte Häuser und dann auch so, wie wir unser Selbstverständnis hatten, mit der genialen Musik, genialen Dilettanten. Einfach machen war unser Motto eigentlich, ja, weil ich meine, die Lebensumstände waren recht preiswert, man musste nicht viel tun dafür, um hier zu überleben. Die Mieten waren billig und man konnte einfach machen.
Und Berlin hat mir im Grunde das Gefühl auch von Hoffnung gegeben, weißt du, von Freiraum, von Toleranz. Meine Wahrnehmung war, dass ich auf einer Insel lebe, weißt du.
At a press conference on the evening of November 9, 1989, Gunter Schabowski, a GDR government spokesman, completely, unexpectedly announced an immediate freedom of travel for GDR citizens. What was not intended at that time became reality within a few hours. The wall fell down.
Deshalb haben wir uns dazu entschlossen, heute eine Regelung zu treffen, die es jedem Bürger der DDR möglich macht, über Grenzübergangspunkte der DDR auszureisen.
Wann tritt das in Kraft?
Das tritt nach meiner Kenntnis, ist das sofort. Unverzüglich.
Dass man zu dieser Zeit da in dieser Stadt ist und plötzlich bricht der Ostblock zusammen, Perestroika, Gorbi-Gorbi-Rufe, dann dieser Kommentar, ja, ja, ab sofort ist die Mauer offen, zack, war die offen.
The fall of the Berlin Wall caused an incredible euphoria in the city. All the people from East and West Germany celebrated this German reunification with a massive and emotional party for the world to see. Everything seemed to be possible. However, at that time, no one knew how exactly the city would develop. The techno-metropolis Berlin has emerged from two basic trends. First, there was this new techno sound from Detroit. And second, this feeling of an insular life in this former divided city, Berlin. In particular, the opportunities for self-fulfillment in West Berlin attracted a very specific clientele of people. Most of the clubs in Berlin started as places for illegal underground parties back in the days. Today, hardly any of these old clubs exist.
Nach dem Ende der Teilung war einfach so extrem viel Leerstand hier und das wurde natürlich genutzt.
Dass Berlin also so beliebt wurde, also für diese Electronic Music Community, lag daran, dass A, durch den Mauerfall erstmal eine unglaubliche Stimmung freigesetzt worden ist. B, dass
wir keine Sperrstunde hatten, also eine Beschränkung. Und dass C dann diese Räume da waren im Ostteil der Stadt. Und D, der vierte Punkt, dass die Behörden uns diesen Freiraum ließen. Die Politik hatte andere Probleme. Sie mussten den Verkehr lösen, zwei Staatensysteme zusammenführen. In dieser Phase, das dauerte so 5-6 Jahre, gab es so eine Art kulturelle Freiheit.
Marusha, a successful and famous German DJ and music producer, started her own techno radio show in 1990. The radio program was broadcast on the last remaining GDR radio station, DT64. This show was called Dance Hall and was at the time one of the first techno music programs within the German radio. Later, the show was renamed into Rave Satellite.
There were so many deserted buildings and like bunkers and underground stations. And there was just a perfect place for all these people to throw parties. That was like the thing, you know, people would throw illegal parties here. It was very hip, very fashionable, you know.
My first time to Berlin, I actually was invited here with through Tresor. At the time when I arrived in Berlin, the music had really, I mean, people had really taken to the music, so the club scene was definitely a little bit more developed. I mean, there were more people. Like in Detroit, it was still kind of a niche thing for what we were doing.
Also das UFO war eigentlich eine Spielstätte für Acid House Music. Techno war noch gar nicht da, war noch nicht angekommen. Das war super. Also ich meine, man kommt aus sich heraus, es war alles so ein bisschen unfertig, ein, zwei Lämpchen und eine improvisierte Bar, das reichte aus. Und das Schöne war eigentlich immer, was auch sich später wiederholte, das Zusammentreffen von jungen Menschen in dunklen Räumen.
...1991, als wir den Planet aufgemacht haben in der Köpenicker Straße, da ist ein Traum in Erfüllung gegangen. Und wir hatten eigentlich am ersten Abend hatten wir nur so ein kleines Knickleuchtstäbchen an die Straße gehangen, weil wir ja nicht auffallen wollten und jetzt nicht auch noch die Polizei aufmerksam machen wollten. Jetzt machen wir hier eine illegale Party.
One of the most outstanding events of music history was the Love Parade. What started in 1989 with 150 participants grew from a vision to a big movement. The peak was reached in 1999, where 1.5 million people from all over the world turned Berlin into the ultimate techno city.
Meine Motivation, diese Love Parade zu machen, war zum einen, um diese Musik aus der Nacht auch zum Tag erscheinen zu lassen, zum einen. Zum anderen, das auf die Straße zu bringen, weil ich halt diese Idee der Street Party hatte toll fand. Und weil ich dann auch überlegt habe, wir melden es einfach als Demonstration an für Friede, Freude, Eierkuchen. Abrüstung, also nicht nur mit Waffen, sondern auch zwischenmenschlich. Freude, Musik als Verständigung der, durch Musik und Musik auch als neue Form der Kommunikation und Eierkuchen für die gerechte Nahrungsmittelverteilung. Uns war das erstmal egal, wohin das geht. Mir nicht, weil ich habe irgendwie die Vision gehabt, lass uns doch das immer wieder machen. Das habe ich aufs erste Plakat auch drauf geschrieben. This year and forever.
Just such a great feeling to know all of these people gathered for this music that I may have been instrumental in progressing.
I was maybe 14. I was in my living room at home together with two friends, and we were lying in the bed and watching the Love Parade. I think it was one of the first time I heard about this kind of music, or like I saw how the people dance and the lights everywhere, the music, the hard techno going on. I think in 1996 or 7, I went the first time to Love Parade. We had some color clothes for sure, maybe yellow shirt, blue trouser, a cappy, and I had like blonde hairs. And that time I had some dreadlocks. I don't know, I had like shaved hairs. I had a piercing here, and a piercing there. And we're walking there like little ravers.
And it was like an experience that you just, it's a lifetime, once in a lifetime experience. That was breathtaking.
Also ich finde es immer wieder faszinierend sehen, wie viele Leute da waren. Also 1999 1,5 Millionen und dann später die Jahre 750.000. Und ich meine, das ist auch schon eine unglaubliche Zahl, immer noch, ja. Wenn man dann so weiß, die kommen aus Holland, aus Polen, aus Italien, Australien, USA, Japan, aus der ganzen Welt kamen die zusammen. Und Westbam hat das mal gesagt, das fand ich ganz schön, dass wir eigentlich, ohne es zu wollen, Völkerverbindung gemacht haben. Ne?
That was a global iconic event.
The Love Parade had a magical power of attraction for many DJs. Being a DJ is both a curse and a blessing at the same time. On the one hand, there are numerous and varied work opportunities due to the large number of clubs. On the other hand, due to the large number of DJs, there is an extreme competition in terms of performances and fees.
Auf allen Medien sieht man halt, dass DJ eigentlich der neue Rockstar ist. Als wir angefangen haben, das für uns als eine Karriere anzusehen, als das, was wir als Lebensinhalt sehen, war das so, wir haben die Schule gemacht, wir haben unsere ersten Platten gemacht, hatten 2 Wochen im Monat genügend Geld, um uns ordentlich zu verpflegen. Die letzten 2 Wochen im Monat mussten wir halt Spaghetti mit Tomatensauce essen. Und es war ein harter Anfang, wir haben aber halt auch alles auf eine Karte gesetzt.
You're God. You're like the man or the woman of the hour. Like, you're gonna, like, you're the reason people are dancing right now and they're moving.
It's true that everybody's a DJ these days.
If you throw a stone in Berlin, you'll probably hit the head of a DJ.
There's definitely a high standard here. When you come and play in Berlin, your stuff gotta be together. Practice, you do your homework for gigs in Berlin.
So especially when there's cities that only have one big club or two big clubs, they're only booking the main people. Somewhere like Berlin, where there is 100 clubs, okay, you don't have that problem. Like, you can have one little bar down the street that plays some weird 80s goth music, techno, and it's fine.
It's not easy to make money with that here, but you definitely get a lot of gigs and you get a lot of places to play.
If you live here and there's some competition for sure, yeah? Because there are so many DJs from around the world, from every country around the world, even the DJs who are born here in Berlin, I think it's very hard for them to really find a place where they fit in and where they can play.
Yeah, for me it was kind of hard to start off in Berlin, because afterwards, once you go outside of the city and start playing like in other countries, you realize that Berlin was already the best place to play.
Es ist heutzutage einfach nicht mehr so, dass du die Welt eroberst, weil du ein guter DJ bist, sondern dein erstes Bekanntwerden ist eben durch ein gutes Release oder ein Release, das eben Anklang findet. Und dann geht's halt los mit Bookings.
No, I don't have competition.
Not you.
There's no competition for me.
The creative factory of DJs is their music studio. Their own sounds are produced. Carolina has been given the opportunity to look over a very special DJ's shoulder. Monolink has invited her to his place. For him, being a DJ is both a musical and an artistic overall experience.
This handmade music, I would say, until I moved to Berlin and I like got to know the electronic music, which I hadn't really been in touch with before. It was a completely new way of listening to music for me. Suddenly it was not about hearing someone's story, but it was like about feeling the story. It was like body music, and I got really excited about it. And at first I was, I even felt a little bit bad, because I felt like I abandoned the old masters that I stuck to for very long. Like Bob Dylan was my hero and the Beatles. And then suddenly there was just this kick drum, you know? And it felt really good. And then I wanted to make kick drum music. What I really like here is like there's a no photo policy, and that really changes a lot of the vibe when people are not filming.
For both club owners and visitors, it is extremely important that everything that happens in the club also stays in the club and within this club community.
Es hat sich natürlich von Berlin, dieses No-Photo-Policy und anonym feiern gehen, das hat sich natürlich schon auch so ein bisschen raus in die Welt getragen. Mhm. Also jetzt, wenn du in vielen Clubs weltweit hast du mittlerweile halt einfach dieses, okay, wir wollen anonym bleiben, hier gibt's keine Fotos.
Another reason that makes Berlin's club scene so unique is the strict door policy, which doesn't exist in that specific way anywhere else. There are no fixed rules. It's all decided at the club's door. In Berlin, bouncers have a kind of celebrity status. To get a personal point of view, Carolina met a Katharina, who is a selector in Berlin.
When you approach a place, you should be there and not just being hanging on the phone, you know, doing 20,000 other things and then trying to get in somewhere. No, because somebody's there trying to talk to you to figure out if you're right for this place or not. And then if you're just not there, how it's very easy to send someone away. So always be present. And sometimes it's really, I know other people would say you shouldn't, but I think sometimes you should smile. I met people and I saw them in the line and I was like, nah, he's like in a fucked up mood. and he doesn't really care if he gets in, but whatever. And then he came up to me and we started talking and I don't know, all of a sudden he started smiling. It was really nice short chat. And then he had like this little split between the teeth and I was like, okay, get in there.
Like, yeah. Okay.
So people turn out to be really sweet somehow or just shine their light. Still at the end of the night, you know, when I go inside a club and take a look around, who's in there, who's connecting, who's not, you still feel responsible for this little crowd that you let in there. I start usually working from 11 p.m. or maybe midnight. Shifts until 6 are okay, but most of them were like until 8 a.m. There's like this window. Midnight till 3, you have like many people approaching. 4 to 5, it's okay. You start relaxing and talk to your colleagues. And then from 6 to 8, you feel like you're dying. I think in general, people who care more about music, or honestly care about music, they are, well, I feel them as really friendly. And yeah, they know how to behave. And there are certain rules which you have to stick to. You know, you gotta know the rules to know how to break them. You always hear about the tourists thing and that there are too many tourists in the city, but it is a great city, it is attractive, it has a great music scene, and it's, in my opinion, it isn't something you shouldn't complain about. People are coming here and they're willing to experience this nightlife thing and they're willing to pay the price, you know?
I mean, it's like people go, oh, techno tourists, I hate them, like, they're ruining everything. Hey, if it wasn't for people like that, like, the city would turn into, like, a regular city.
Die nighttime economy mit all seinen Gesichtern zieht Wochenende für Wochenende, weißt du, Tausende von Leuten, die das erforschen wollen.
If so many people didn't come, maybe all these clubs wouldn't be able to stay open, you know? So maybe it's good to have all these people coming here.
I think tourists are, like, keeping up the night until those elite party people, I'd say, or those who come just like to go out party later.
get into the club, you know, and there's already an atmosphere. And thanks to whom? Thanks to the tourists who stand there in line from 11 p.m. So come on.
Berlin is one of the most visited centers of national and international city tourism. Compared to 2001, tourism increased by 250%. In Berlin, there are nearly 500 music venues. 67% of the clubs are based on electronic dance music. On the weekend alone, about 50,000 people dance in those clubs.
You should be like a dancer before to be DJ, because you can really like to have like two points of view. You have the dance floor point of view and you have the DJ point of view, and you really can understand the people and what the people need, you know?
Yeah.
And then I came here, and I think it was a natural process, because if you like music, Berlin is the city.
Yeah.
It's completely the city. Because some people say like hobby, I think it's like passion.
Yeah.
But you have here so much like quality of club. The lineups and things is amazing.
10, 15 years ago, there was not so many clubs like now. Now you have every corner in Berlin, there's a techno club.
Du kannst in jeder Stunde, zu jedem Tag, zu jeder Uhrzeit, in der Woche, in der ganzen Woche kannst du ausgehen und findest irgendwo eine Party. Und das kenne ich in keiner anderen Stadt der Welt.
Like in North America, people come out at, let's say, midnight. They see their friends, they talk, hey, how are you? How much rent do you pay? And then at like 2 o'clock, the club's finished. So there's not really a lot of time to get into the music.
Also stell dir das mal vor, Berlin hätte eine Polizeistunde um 2 Uhr, dann würde dieses Nachtfieber gar nicht stattfinden.
You could go here to a club basically for 72 hours in a row. It doesn't exist anywhere. There is no closing time in a club here. You could go in on Friday and come out on Monday morning. And there's always the after party of the after party and another after hour. Hey, but that's not the last after hour. Maybe there's 2 more after hour on the way. So it's kind of, it's an ongoing process with this after hour thing.
Die Leute kommen hier heute auch nach Berlin. Immer noch wollen sie wissen, hier gibt es Orte, da geht vieles. Das macht eine wirkliche Sucht aus.
It's crazy, like how can you go out on Thursday and come home on Tuesday? Like, where else can you do that? Like, it's insanity. It's not even nightlife, it's just night and day life. It's endless, it's crazy.
Es zeigt auch so ein Bedürfnis der Menschen, so eine Sehnsucht nach so einem Ort, wo man wirklich mal nicht auf die Uhr schauen muss.
The techno culture is based on a revolutionary alternative ideology, which has been adopted by more and more people. But with growth comes popularity, which made those two worlds of mystical underground and tough reality collide. Quickly, the commercial potential of the scene was discovered and then was exploited to be mass marketable. Judging some particular movements, opinions differ within the very diverse techno scene nowadays.
What is commercial and what is underground nowadays? Because if I see something, some music underground, maybe for another person is already commercial.
Und ich denke, dass die Gäste auch merken, dass die Stimmung in Berlin weniger kapitalgeprägt ist als in anderen Ländern, und anderen Städten. Schlimmste Beispiel ist Ibiza. Also ich war vor 15 Jahren letztes Mal da. Was da vor 15 Jahren war, war es schon schwierig. Aber also es ist auf jeden Fall genau die andere Seite der Techno-Welt. Für mich ist es genau die andere Seite der Techno-Welt. Nämlich immer größer, schneller, noch mehr Prunk, noch mehr Protz, was Techno eigentlich gar nicht ist. Nur so halb ernst nehmen, wenn ich das Gefühl habe, dass die Kunst zu so einem Job verkommt. Das habe ich manchmal das Gefühl. Das gibt es sowohl natürlich auf der Veranstalterseite, gibt es aber natürlich auf der Künstlerseite auch, dass man das Gefühl hat, der Künstler arbeitet sich am Wochenende ab hinterm DJ-Pult. Aber umso schöner ist es natürlich, wenn man andere sieht, die schon irgendwie 20, 25 Jahre dabei sind und mit voller Leidenschaft noch auf der Bühne stehen und einfach lieben und leben. Und das sind auch meistens die, die langfristig erfolgreicher sind.
Commercial aspect is not necessarily a bad thing, you know, because maybe when people are looking at the commercial aspect, they'll discover the underground.
There's a lot of DJ friends of mine, they playing kind of underground music, but they're playing in front of 10,000 people and they got in a way commercial and very, very known.
You can have such like a diverse scene where you can have some mainstream places that we don't even know about because they're so mainstream, but you can have some underground places that are so underground that like I will never have heard of it or none of my friends will, like it's that underground.
Everything is so commercial now and it's crap music and I don't want to be a part of it, then I'm part of the problem. Not part of the solution.
Gegen Geld verdienen ist nicht zu sagen. Kommt auch an, wie es verdient wird.
The club culture has found a permanent place in the city, which is also anchored in cultural politics. Nevertheless, many clubs have been struggling with a displacement process for many years. At the same time, the city still offers enough space and opportunities to start new clubs.
Die Zukunft Berlin ist auf jeden Fall dunkel und nass.
Wenn die Prognose jetzt Berlin ist, dann kann ich sagen, ändert sich in den nächsten 15 Jahren wahrscheinlich nichts, weil das Berlin ist irgendwie in der Hinsicht immer gleich geblieben, aber im positiven Sinne. Der Rave ist einfach stabil hier. Das ist hier so wie die verspätete S-Bahn.
I still think it is the capital city of techno. And it will be still in the next years for sure.
It won't shift to another city. Like if this scene's gonna continue anywhere, it's gonna continue here. Because it's got the foundation for it here.
Ja, ich glaube, dass die Zeiten sich definitiv geändert haben. Ne? Aber ich glaube auch, dass viele Clubmacher der ersten Stunde auch viel dazugelernt haben, dass man da Wege findet, um einen Club zu machen.
Dass es musikalisch ist oder auch clubbezogen ist, dass sich alles ein bisschen Richtung Underground, also bewusst, ob das jetzt
eine Oldschool wieder
ist. Oldschooliger.
Ja, Oldschool,
also,
wieder.
Dass man versucht, wieder kleiner zu werden, was die Größe der Partys betrifft. Dass wieder mehr auf die Subkulturnischen im Techno, im Underground-Techno, dass da wieder mehr Zugriff drauf passieren wird.
Ich hoffe nicht, dass es zu teuer wird, und dass ein Club aufzubauen überhaupt noch realisierbar ist.
Berlin ist so ein Hingucker, weil es ist immer noch die billigste Hauptstadt der Welt. Und alle wollen hier irgendwie kaufen, 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 kaufen. Das ist auch schon so, dass Clubs verdrängt werden deswegen, weil plötzlich Investoren das Haus gekauft haben und haben was anderes vor in der Location.
Aber es ist auf jeden Fall auch noch möglich, Orte zu finden, die bespielbar sind. Und es ist auf jeden Fall auch noch möglich, sich kreative Freiräume zu suchen. Und wenn man dann in diesen kreativen Freiräumen mit viel Energie und Liebe, Leidenschaft und Zuverlässigkeit agiert, dann kann man diese Freiräume auch zum Teil behalten.
Ich kann natürlich sein, dass die Karawane woanders hinzieht. Weißt du? Detroit wäre heute so ein Thema oder eine andere Stadt. Dennoch glaube ich, dass in Berlin dieser Geist bleibt.
Well, let's just hope that, you know, the creative person will use that to be creative in a creative way.
I don't know. I see a part of a gang going very, very deep and slow with their music. And there's a lot of DJs, they playing, I feel like they play the trance of the 90s, a little bit part with techno, and then it's the other side, the techno side here in Berlin with Berghain. I'm very curious.
I feel like Berlin still preserved most of its vibe, which is really good. There's always like a stage for new stuff here.
I think that there is a discernible thing about Berlin music. They're pushing the envelope, you know, definitely. More so on Berlin than any other city, you know, in the world, actually.
Es geht einfach um Gefühl von Freiheit, es geht um Gefühl von Gleichheit. Das sind ja die Ursprünge von Techno. So hat alles angefangen. Es ging nicht darum, was man für eine Religion hat, was für eine Hautfarbe, was für Sexualität. Das war alles egal. Man war in einem Raum, hat getanzt und alle waren gleich vor der Musik.
No matter how you look at it, Berlin has Techno and Techno has Berlin. And this is something precious and valuable, which can be experienced 24/7.
Dass in Berlin, trotz alledem, was auch draußen passiert, in Berlin ist immer noch ein anderer Sound und ein anderer Vibe. Ich weiß nicht, was es ist. Hier werden dieselben Platten gespielt wie auch woanders, aber irgendwie ist es doch immer anders hier. Aber das Wort Berlin funktioniert immer woanders.
I don't know what the Berlin sound is. I don't know. Like every time I make music, I just make what I make. And when I go to clubs, it's always different kinds of music. I asked my girlfriend, do you know what the Berlin sound is? And she's like, yeah, of course. There's like the Berghain sound, there's like this sound. I'm like, the Bar 25 sound. I'm like, oh, can you show me? Because I don't really know.
Beste Beispiel ist wirklich, wenn man ins Berghain geht. Und da wird halt so richtig schöner Berghain schroffer Song gespielt. Und dann bist du mal woanders in der Welt und da wird derselbe Song gespielt. Da ist dann, also, da sind dann weniger auf der Tanzfläche. Also, das ist halt doch echt ein krasser Unterschied.
The language between all the people here is music. There are so many different artists here, such a huge musical collective of people. What basically bonds everyone is like this love for music, for electronic music.
Sound passt ja einfach so gut her nach Berlin. Ich bin heute irgendwie, wo ich zum Studio gelaufen bin, habe ich auch so mir Kopfhörer reingesteckt, habe ich irgendwie das aktuelle Reinkarjoga-Album gehört. Und die Stadt ist eigentlich manchmal auch ein bisschen hässlich, muss ich sagen, aber mit der Musik. Blüht die einfach, das passt ja. So krass. Du läufst und denkst so, boah, wie geil. Weißt du, das ist halt so, das ist so eine Symbiose, die Stadt und die Musik zusammen.
Mich kann man die ganze Zeit missverstehen, Musik aber nicht. Und das ist das halt Verbindende, das schöne Verbindende. Und das bringt auch die Menschen dann, ohne dass man erst ein Motto braucht oder sonst irgendwas, eigentlich ganz schnell zusammen, tanzenderweise.
During this journey through the club development and techno movement in Berlin, Carolina only scratched the surface of discovery, but indeed got to feel the spirit of the city. The urban charisma, the vibes, the creative spirit and awareness of life is what makes Berlin one of a kind. Most remarkable and impressive is that this whole scene started with a handful of visions and then spread throughout a whole city. What began as a small grain suddenly arose to something which never stopped moving and is still prospering. It keeps evolving every second and stays alive through a strong community. It doesn't matter whether you're a DJ or someone who just wants to listen and let go for a while. You will shape this whole subculture. Everything is based on peaceful coexistence and mutual acceptance. It's an emulsion of connected spirituality and mystical anonymity. Transferring the mind is often a key concern while dancing and listening to techno music. Although techno has become a globally linked phenomenon, in Berlin, techno is still something different. Here, the city and the music are interactive. The spirit gives you the freedom to be yourself, sink in, and forget about the world that passes by so fast. Berlin's techno was in the first place historical, but there is also future in the past. And that's what's most important. It's still alive. If you love techno, you cannot miss Berlin. This city is a special place for alternative cultural consumption, and there are many secret corners still to discover. The sound of Berlin is something everybody has to experience for themselves. So start listening, dive in, and get seduced by the sound of Berlin.
Oh, you swallow me inside.
Muss ich noch abgepudert werden?
No.
No, I think there's like a special
tool. Oh, this is shit.
I cleaned up a little bit for the interview.
Snacks, snacks, snacks.
Schluck den Druck.
Making me shy now.
Yeah. I'm shy.
That's me.
Ich freue mich jedes Mal, wenn ich auf der Tanzfläche bin.
Arschloch. First word I learn here. Arschloch. Geht weg.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Nee, ist vielleicht auch nicht alles richtig.
Die Schublade stecken.
Wie weit bist du?
Ziemlich fertig.
Danke, Matthias.
Dankeschön, danke.
Sind wir schon fertig?